Hi, my name is Robert Liedkamp, and welcome to our new series called You Can Read Your Destiny. This is going to be for people who are relatively new to the system, who don't understand some of the fundamentals and like to learn it, people that either have the book or don't have the book, the books, the cards of your destiny, and love cards. For those who do not have the book, this series will teach you all the fundamentals, the terminology, the structure, and also how to use the online software, because you're going to need to have access to your yearly spreads in order to get anything meaningful from this system. There's a lot in the books that it's not covered here, but the basic and most important information is going to be available to you just by using the online software, which you can use for $10 a month. Now, for those who do have the books, you might learn some new things about the software and how to use it, and you might learn some new things that you haven't heard before, maybe you didn't read about in the books. So we're going to talk about that, those things in this class. We're going to start at the very beginning. We're going to always use this online software as a tool, which is available on 7thunders.com. And today's lesson is about you and your cards. So let's just talk about this a little bit. Every day of the year is governed by one of the 53 symbols. That's 52 plus the Joker. And here you're looking at an image of all the birthdays and the card that governs that day of the year. This card is called your birth card. It's most likely your most important card, even though you'll find that the other ones I'm going to mention next, sometimes you will identify more with those, and sometimes you'll identify more with your birth card. But we always include the birth card in all of our work and calculations. There's a rhythm. There is a formula to determine which card is governed on which day of the year. We're not going to go into that because the software does it for you, and you can just look it up here or in the books. You also have ruling cards. You have what's called a planetary ruling card, and you also have what we call a decanate ruling card, which we've been using a lot in the last few years. The planetary ruling card comes from your sun sign. So there can be as many as 12 birthdays for any particular card in the deck. Like the King of Clubs and Queen of Clubs each have 12 birthdays. Every month has one of those cards. And yet there are other cards that only have one birthday. The King of Spades and Ace of Hearts, for example, only have one birthday in the entire year. So there's a formula again. Now the ruling card, when you have like many birthdays, the ruling card gives you this additional information about that birthday. And even the cards that only have one birthday have a ruling card. Okay, like all King of Spades, for example, which are born on January 1st, they all have the planetary ruling card of the Five of Clubs. Okay, so that is determined by the sun sign. And when you know the sun sign of a person, then you know what planet rules their sun sign. You know, and you have to know what the correlation is. Like Saturn rules Capricorn, Moon rules Cancer, Leo rules the sun, Mercury rules Virgo and Gemini, and so forth and so on. And the software will actually do it for you. It'll figure out your planetary ruling card for you. Okay. There's also a decanate ruler, which is based on how many degrees of your sun sign it was the day you were born. We're not going to get into how to figure that out. And the program does not do it for you because it doesn't do astrology charts, which you have to do in many cases in order to figure that out. But we'll talk about mostly about the birth card and the planetary ruling card. We might mention the decanate here or there, but this is what we're going to focus on in these lessons. Now, it's important to know that if you are born within 45 minutes, let's say, and sometimes even an hour close to midnight, you might be a different card than you think, because this system uses what we call true solar time, which you may also think about could be like sundial time. Like, what's the real time? You know, we live in a world that has time zones, and these time zones can be quite long. Like I think the Eastern time zone starts up there in Maine somewhere and goes all the way to Knoxville, Tennessee, or something like that. So it's a very long, and we're all saying that the time is the same in that whole zone. But in fact, true solar time, sundial time, is going to be different on wherever you are in that thing. So this is why if you're born close to midnight, you have to do an analysis to see, because you might be the day before or you might be the day after. But understanding your birth card, it really tells you all about your life and your karma. And we're just going to look at the life spread here of this person. It's a person born on February 26th, okay? Now, all the spreads kind of look alike. They all have these seven cards with planetary symbols above them, and they have these other cards. Okay, these long-range Pluto result environment displacement cards and so forth. The life spread, though, tells you what your lifetime karma is in all different departments of life, like relationships, work, money, health, and other areas. Okay, we're not going to get into that really deeply, but you can explore your life spread. We don't have specific interpretations for all the life spread cards. Like if you click on the Five of Clubs in Venus here, what you're getting is the interpretation of this card in a year, if it happened in a year. But if you're looking at the life spread, this affects the entire life. And there's aspects of that card in a life spread that probably won't be mentioned in this interpretation of the yearly spread. Five of Clubs in Venus, for example. But you'll get a general idea about that, you know, and it's really good to kind of get to know your life spread cards and read about them. You should know that your blessing cards are the Jupiter card, your birth card is a blessing card, your Venus card, and the most difficult cards would be Saturn and Pluto. And even Mars, if it's an odd numbered card, like you can see that the Queen of Clubs here has a Three of Diamonds and Nine of Spades in Mars. And these are difficult cards. The most difficult cards are sevens and nines. These are the spiritual cards. They're great for spirituality. They're great for spiritual growth, but they do present challenges and problems on a mundane level. Okay. So very important to keep in mind that sevens and nines are the most challenging, but the most rewarding on the spiritual level. So, you know, most people aren't that interested in the spiritual stuff. They don't want to have all these challenges and problems. But when you have had a lot of those in your lifetime, you gradually evolve to a place where you welcome these challenging cards because they're helping you to clear out areas inside of yourself where there needs to be love given to yourself to heal some emotional and other types of trauma that you've experienced in this life or previous lives. Every birth card has its own karmic package, and it's determined by the card itself and its ruling card, but it's also determined by the cards in the life spread, and also there's a thing called karma cards. So every card has two karma cards. And this software does not tell you what these karma cards are, unfortunately. I can tell you how to look it up, but it's a little bit complicated, and it's not really, probably not the best thing to go over because it's kind of complicated. So if you really want to know the karma cards, you can go to, you can go to the book. The books have it. The Love Cards book has your karma cards there. First and second karma cards. But anyway, these karma cards also tell a lot about the life story, and they become extremely important when you look at your life in an overall manner and see the patterns that you've been living out of your whole life. Okay. So this is the basic thing. What we're going to get into in our next lesson is all about your spreads, your yearly spreads that tell you what's going to happen, when it's going to happen. And we're going to discuss the software more and how to use it. Okay, so we'll see you then, and thank you for being here.